The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 12, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on August 18, 1973, in London, England.
Translation. Never was there a time when I did not exist, nor you, nor all these kings, nor in future shall any of us cease to be.
This is very important class. The modern scientists, philosophers, they say that after finishing this body, no more exists. Finish, everything is finished. This is not new. In only time also there were atheists like Charvak Muni. He also said like that. Bhasmi bhutasya dehasya puno kutah punaragamana bhavet. So why you are worrying about next life? As soon as this body is burned into ashes, everything is finished. According to Vedic funeral ritualistic ceremony, the body is burned. There are three ends of the body. Either to become stool, or to become ashes, or to become earth. Those who are bearing the body, just like the Christian Mahometan too, the body becomes earth. Everything from the earth which has come out. Dust thou art, dust thou beest. This beautiful body, nice body, will become earth. And those are burning, so that body will become ashes. And those who throw the body to be eaten by jackals and crows, they become stones. This is the end of the body. We are taking so much care of this body. But the ultimate end of this body is either stool, earth or ashes. So foolish person who has the bodily concept of life, they are thinking, after all this body will be finished, for so long the body is there, senses are there, let us enjoy. Why so much restriction? No illicit sex, no gambling, no. These are all nonsense. Let us enjoy life. This is atheistic life. Foolish life. They do not know. No. The body is not all. This is the first lesson to understand what is spiritual life, what is spiritual knowledge. With all aspects we do not know. Therefore Krishna, first of all, slapped Arjuna. Asatyanam sutastam prajnavadam. He do not know what is this fact and talking like a very learned man. Just try to understand what is true. Not to eva ahamidya. First thing is that nasa. We have no nasam. We never die. That will be explained later on. Oh, more clearly. We do not die. Nasam. At any time. It's not that sometimes we die and sometimes. No. Any time. Jat. At any time. So, sir, you are Supreme Personality of Godhead. You may not die. But we die. We are ordinary living entities. But Krishna says, nasam na tam na, na aham, na tu eva aham, jatru nasam na tam. Neither you nor I. So it may be, I am your friend, and you are Krishna, therefore the others will die. No! Name is Anadipa. Neither this, all these people, all these soldiers, the kings who are assembled here, they will also not. There is no end. They will never die. So, nachaiva na bhavishyama. It is not that we did not exist in the past and we are existing at present. That is, everyone knows. So in the future, don't think that we may not exist. Na bhavishyama. It is not that we shall not exist in the future. Na bhavishyama not exist, and it's another not. Two nots makes one yes. Two negative makes one positive. So that's why you have two negative. Na chaiva na bhavishyama. Na bhavishyama means not to exist in the future. That is not. That means we shall exist. Na chaiva na bhavishyama. Sarve. All of us. All of you. Not that I am because I am God, because you are my friend, God's friend, and all others. No, everyone. This is not. In the Kathopanishad there is a verse. Nitya Nityanam. Nitya Nityanam. Nityanam means ever existing. Nitya means ever. Always. So, either Krishna or we, every one of us are ever existing. Because we are part and parcel of Krishna. Therefore, if Krishna is ever existing, so we are also there. A particle of gold is gold, qualitatively. The value of gold mine and the gold earring may be different. Gold earring may be, say, $100. But gold mine, millions of dollars. But both of them are gold. Not that it is iron, therefore less value. No. A small point. Krishna is the Supreme Spirit, person. He is all pervading. Everywhere he is present. He is so expansive. We are simply, we are also all pervading, but we being this body. That's all. Krishna is all pervading means throughout the whole creation. Krishna all pervading. And we are also all pervading only in this body. You are all pervading within your body. I know the pains and pleasure of my body. You know the pains and pleasure of your body. So, all pervading means within this body. If I think anywhere, I feel pain. But you will not feel. If I think my body, I will feel pain. You will not feel. Therefore, you are not all pervading, I am not all pervading. But Krishna is all pervading. When I feel pain, Krishna knows it. Vidaham samiti itam. I know everything. That is Krishna. Try to understand these things and between Krishna and us. He is all pervading. But he is nitya, ever existing, we are also ever existing. Nitya, nitya, nam, chetana, chetana, nam. We have got knowledge, Krishna has got knowledge. But we have got limited knowledge, Krishna has got unlimited knowledge. That is the difference. Krishna is also cognizant. He is also acknowledged. Nitya nityanam chetana chetananam. Then what is the difference between Krishna and us? Yes, there is difference. What is that? That Krishna, singular number. Nitya nityanam. Nityanam, this is plural number. Chetana chetananam. Chetananam, this is plural number. So there is one person, singular number, are as a pura dharma, we jivas. Anantaya kalpati, jivas, that is described the dimension of the jiva. I have several times explained. Kesagra satabhava sas satabhava kalpitasya cha. First of all, divide the tip of the hair into 100 parts. Then take another one of the parts, 100 parts, again divide into 100 parts. That is small, less than atom, that is the magnitude of the jiva. And they are anantaya kalpate. There is no limit. There is no limit how many divinities are there. If you search out, after passing through, if you search out, you will find millions of living entities, germs. Even from the hole of your womb, there is a small hole, and there are ants. Hundreds and thousands will come out. So similarly, within the hole, within the earth, within the air, within the fire even, there are joints and fires, worms in the fire. These aspects they do not know. They simply think, because nitya, nitya means ever existing, so in the fire the living entity does not die. They sterilize. Now it is sterilized, that is all wrong. Sterilized means the body is killed. They are not these. That is abortion. The body is killed. Contrary, the body is killed. But the soul is not killed. If you make some inconvenience to the soul who has taken shelter in the womb and he killed the body, then he will have to search out another body. This is going. Just see how much rascal civilization is going on. They are thinking they are killed. This way killed, that way killed. No. You, it is sinful because you create inconvenience to that particular soul. You are taking shelter. Karmanādaivanatrena-viha-bhoti. By his karma, he has been given shelter to develop a body. And if you kill that body, that means you go against the order of the Supreme, Devanatrim. Suppose you are destined to occupy some room and somebody does not allow you to enter the room. Is it not criminal? Is it criminal? Unlawful detention, unlawful. Even in the state. Similarly, a living entity is developing one body, and if you kill that, you become immediately criminal, punishable. And the living entity who is checked to develop the body, he is put into inconvenience. He is also sinful. He is also sinful. Therefore, it may be simply he is wandering from one womb to another, one womb to another, one womb to another. Because he committed that sinful activity, abortion. Now, the man who causes this abortion, he also being punished, that he will never see the light of this world. He will simply we have to be one womb to another, one womb to another. One. So nature's punishment is like that. But these foolish people, they do not know. Nitya nityana. So every living entity is nitya. And Krishna is nitya. He is similar number, we are two number. That is the difference. We are many, Krishna is one. There cannot be many Krishna. But there are many living. So what is the difference between the similar number? That is also stated here. Eka bahunam jo vidudhati kaman. This one similar number is supplying all the necessities of this pura dharma. Is it not fact? we are very much disturbed over population. There is no nonsense. Krishna is quite able. If there is overpopulation, there cannot be overpopulation because there are already ananta living entities. Why do you speak of overpopulation? It is already there. You cannot count. There is no question of it. There are already overpopulation. And they can be provided by Krishna. Because you bahuna ambedhatina. Krishna is not limited. He is also unlimited. He can provide unlimited living entities. There is no scarcity of food. So this theory, the upper population, is nonsense. Is also nonsense. There cannot be overpopulation. But there is a restriction by nature. Nature will restrict production of food if there are demons. Nature will not provide the demons. He will find in the Srimad Bhagavatam, fourth canto. Nature is quite prepared to supply all the food. But as soon as there are number of demons, because the whole plan is to correct. Just like the criminals are sent to the prison house for being corrected. So that they may not again commit criminals. That is the purpose of. Similarly, we are all criminals who are in this material world. The purpose is to be correct. We wanted to imitate Krishna, to become Krishna, and therefore we violated the orders of Krishna, and that criminality means material life. Krishna bhulya jeeva bhogavan chakare pasati mayakare japatiya. This is Maya. This material world, Maya, this body is false, Maya. So we have to accept this body because we wanted to enjoy. To enjoy, you enjoy with this body, particular body. Either human body, or dog's body, or cat's body, or demigod's body, you get as you desire, you get a material body and enjoy. This is material life. So Krishna also, although in the material life, Krishna provided all necessities of life. Daily there is seasonal changes, you get seasonal fruits, flowers, grains, and all necessities. He is still giving chance, especially to the human being, that you get all supplies, necessities. Ekoji bahunam vidurādhikāma, all necessities. But again, you divide your consciousness, Krishna consciousness. That is the plan. But if you do not revive your Krishna consciousness, if you simply enjoy the sunset, then there will be restriction of supply. This is it. There is restriction of supply. Therefore, there will be no rain. And if there is no rain, what factory will do? You will ask them. You can manufacture scissors and knives and buckets of plastic, but you cannot prepare rice and wheat. That is not possible, sir. That will depend on rain. So immediately rains will be restricted. Now, you all chew all this kakar. What is this kakar? This stone particles, what are called them? In Hindi it is called kankar, Indian. Pebbles the big, small, sand. Yeah. So you can eat that. Why there is no rain? That is also eatable. The peacocks they eat, the pigeons they eat. Yes. They can eat. You have seen? So everything is eatable. There is no question of overpopulation. Overpopulation is already there. Anantaya kalpate. So why do you call overpopulation? When there is already fire, why do you say there will be fire? It is already there. But the restriction, He orders. He does not order actually. Just like not every time the police has to be ordered by the superior authority to punish the criminal. They know how to punish. So see, the nature knows how to punish these criminals. Therefore, the scientists are finding now shortage of petrol, shortage of these, shortage of what to do, what to do. This is the position. Otherwise, there is no question of overpopulation. The supply is restricted. That is the problem. Because he supplies all the necessities, the supply is restricted. As we become more and more sinful, and without Krishna consciousness, they will be put into difficulties, they will be dying within the womb, they will be killed within the womb, there will be war, there will be pestilence, there will be famine, there will be earthquake. In so many ways we have to die. Again, take one. Bhutta, paliyate, this business will go. And ultimately when the whole universe is annihilated, then again we take shelter in the body of Mahavishnu and live for in that way without any body. For many millions of years, again there is creation, and then again given chance, or like take another chance, be Krishna conscious. So this is material creation. Bhutta paliyate. As we have got this body, we have got this chance now to become Krishna conscious. And if we meet, then I do not know where I am going next life. But I am not going to die, that's a fact. That will explain in the next one. I am not going to die. So we existed in the past, we are now existing at present, and we shall continue to exist in the future. This is it. But how we shall exist, what kind of body, as a demigod's body, a dog's body, a tree's body, a fish's body, that will depend on my work. Or we go back to home, back to Godhead, Krishna, like we get the spiritual body, like Krishna. Everything is possible. So, it is our business to see what kind of body we shall get next life. Kaptadeham punarjanma naiti mahami pitonto. Actually, if we become Krishna conscious, then after giving up this body, we are no more going to accept any material body. Because spiritual body is already there. That is eternal. The spirit soul is spiritual body. That is never vanquished. It was existing in the past, it is existing now, and it will continue to exist in the future. Because people may say, how is that? How? All things Krishna is speaking. That natu eva aham jatu nasang natsang nimajanati. This actually, we died. Maybe we have taken birth again, but everyone died. How is that? That we do not die. No, it is not the body. But the Krishna is speaking about the soul. Soul is ever existing. It existed in the past, it is existed now, and it will exist. Maybe different type of body. That is Krishna's instruction. The another thing is, the Mahavadi philosopher says that we are one. There is no you and me. Ever one. So, then Krishna is defective. If Krishna says, you, me, all others. So it is not one, it is not homogeneous. We are all individuals. You are individual, I am individual, and all the kings and soldiers, they are all individuals. So the Mayavadi theory that after liberation, everyone becomes one, one lump sum, homogeneous spirit. No. Then Krishna is false. The Mayavadi theory accepted that we become one, lonesome. Then Krishna's theory, not theory, Krishna's actual knowledge, then it becomes false. And if Krishna speaks false, something defective, then where is the use of reading Bhagavad Gita? Why should we read Bhagavad Gita, which is spoken by a person who is defective? No, that's enough. What Krishna is speaking, that is fact. That is fact. Otherwise, why Bhagavad Gita is given so important? So Mayavadi philosophers, they try to interpret in a different way. I mean this, you mean that, some. These Mayavadi philosophers, Vimukta Mani, I am now become liberated. Now I am one with the Supreme. That is Vimukta Mani. I mean, they're thinking like that as a rasta. Actually, it cannot be mixed up. Everything is individual. But they are thinking, therefore this word is used, vimukta manina. Manina means falsely thinking. Jinnera vindakta vimukta manina. Tari asya bhava. Why they are thinking? Because they are not devotees. They do not think that there is another God worshipable. We are all God, now we are mixed up. That is modern. So these Mahavadis, when they think that among the Mahavadi sannyasi, the address is Namo Narayana. That means everyone is thinking that I have already become Narayana. Although they are breaking in the street, therefore, still they are thinking that each of them has become Narayana. And our Vivekananda Swami, he thought, if actually you are Narayana, why you are begging? Therefore he gave a new name, Daridra Narayana, poor Narayana. And if you say poor Narayana, then there is another rich Narayana. So there will be duality, how you support your money. As soon as you say Daridra Narayana, so there is rich Narayana also. So there immediately, it becomes duality, Daitava. So there are so many defects in their philosophy. Therefore, Bhagavad says that vimukta manina, falsely thinking they have become liberated. Why? Tai asya bhava, because they have no information of your lotus feet. So, what is the result? Na arujya kichena paranga padam thakva. They undergo serious penetration austerities. Actually, Mahavadi sannyas is the observer. They do not use any bed. They lie down. That is the structure of Shankara Sampradaya sannyas. Simply on the floor, three times, must take bath. So many strict regulations. And actually, some of them follow. But what you are following? You have given so much reliance. So, Arujya Krishna, after undergoing so severe austerities of life, they approach that they mix or they approach the impersonal effulgence. Just like if you, the Sputnik, you are, but what is that Sputnik? You remain on the star. And as soon as you are tired, they can come back. As soon as you are tired. Otherwise, why they are coming back? But, go, round, back. So long you do not get a shelter, you have to come back. Similarly, these Mahavadis, they mix with the effulgence, Krishna's, Brahma Jyoti. But because there is only existence, but there is no blissfulness of life. So simply existence is not. Suppose if I live for thousands of years, but I have no society, is that very good condition of life? No. Suppose somebody gives me blessing that we will live for thousands of years, but no company, sir. Shall I accept it? This is not possible. Therefore, even though these Mayavadis, they approach actually. Arujya Krishna Parampadam. Parampadam means the impersonal Brahma Jyoti. Arujya Krishna Parampadam. Tataha. Padanti adha. So, why they fall down? Anadita yusmat angaya. because they have neglected your lotus feet. They do not know that there is Vaikuntha Loka, there is Goloka Vrindavan, there is Krishna, there is service of Krishna. These things are unknown to them. On account of this, they fall down. So, the Sarujya Mukti, to become one with the Father, is a false theory, or even if you mix for some time, because there is simply eternity. But we are being part and parcel of Krishna. We are also possess the three transcendental qualities, Sat, Chit, Ananda. As Krishna is Satchidananda Vigraha, we are spiritually also Satchidananda Vigraha, but not exactly like Krishna. Therefore, our Sat eternity sometimes becomes disturbed by falling down on this material world. But we are seeking Ananda, pleasure in this material body, we are never happy. Thank you. Thank you.